Hi, let's talk about the pharynx. The pharynx, as you know, is part of the aerodigestive pathway, a common pathway between the respiratory and digestive systems. And it is divided up into three divisions. Superiorly, we have the nasopharynx. Intermediate, we have the oropharynx. And inferiorly, we have the laryngopharynx. Now, this is a view of the pharynx that we're not going to see in today's session on your donor, but these specimens will be available for your review. Let's take a look at some of these boundaries amongst these spaces. So here is the right nasal cavity, and it is contiguous with the nasopharynx through the choana. Plural, choani. The soft palate can form an imaginary line to form the distal barrier or the inferior barrier between the nasopharynx and the oropharynx. That oropharynx also has an anterior barrier of the palatoglossal folds, which we can see right there. The palatoglossal fold is a fold of mucosa that goes over the palatoglossal muscle, which is one of the extrinsic muscles of the tongue. Together, those palatoglossal folds form the palatoglossal arch. And so the space between those arches is the isthmus, and that's the space between the oral cavity and the oropharynx. We can also see the superior margin of the epiglottic cartilage there, and laterally, it's tough to see here, but there are pharyngoepiglottic folds, which are going to form the boundary between the oropharynx to the superior and the laryngopharynx to the inferior. The laryngopharynx is going to have an inferior border, and it's not patent here, but if we were to open this up here, an inferior border below the cricoid cartilage, that's approximately at the level of the sixth cervical vertebrae. And that's where the laryngopharynx turns into the esophagus. Anteriorly, there's also the laryngeal inlet, the space through which air can be communicated between the laryngeal vestibule and the laryngopharynx. Now let's take a look at what we'll be seeing in this session on your donors. So here we have the posterior wall of the pharynx has been incised and reflected away. And I can see the uvula there. Here is a palatopharyngeal fold formed by mucosa going over the palatopharyngeus muscle, one of the three longitudinal muscles of the pharynx. Here's the soft palate there. So anything above this will be the nasopharynx, the roof of which will have the pharyngeal tonsil. The lateral wall will have the opening to the auditory or Eustachian tube. And then the oropharynx will contain, so let's draw that line again, the uvula. And as we pass through this space here beyond this palatopharyngeal fold, which is the posterior boundary for the fosses, so as we enter into the fosses, we can see the root of the tongue with the lingual tonsil. So there's mucosa-associated lymphoid tissue covering that root of the tongue or the pharyngeal part of the tongue, which is the lingual tonsil there. And as we move into the laryngopharynx, here's that boundary, there's the epiglottis, and here is the pharyngoepiglottic fold just lateral to that, a little squished in there. We can see the laryngeal inlet here, laryngeal inlet. And then beyond the cricoid cartilage, we'll have the esophagus. And lateral to the larynx, so I'll just outline the larynx here, we have this space, these spaces, which are the piriform fossae, or the piriform recesses. And those are spaces in which sometimes foodstuffs or pills can get stuck on their way down to the esophagus. So we've discussed the pharynx and its divisions, the naso, oro, and laryngo pharynxes. And we've also discussed some of the contents of the naso, the oro, and the laryngopharynx. Thank you very much for your time.